This is how users search the web on the desktop. And this is how many users search on mobile. Okay, Google. In fact, a recent study shows that 55% of teens and 41% of adults already use voice search more than once per day. At Google, we always look for innovative ways to help you improve mobile search and drive user engagement back to your app. Let's see a few examples. When I'm ready to plan a Hawaii trip, I can say, "Okay, Google, search for hotels in Maui on TripAdvisor." That's right. The search took me directly to the app on my phone rather than a website. To get into the vacation mood, let's try ordering some pizza. Okay, Google, search for Hawaiian pizza on E24. That's pretty yummy. All I need now is some Hawaiian tunes. Okay, Google, search for Hawaiian music on TuneIn. As you can see, TripAdvisor, E24, TuneIn, and many other apps allow their users to search using voice. They have integrated a feature called Google Now Actions, and so can you. Google Now Actions allow you to take advantage of Google's speech recognition technology to understand natural language and turn it into Android intents delivered to your app. In order to enable voice search in your app, declare an intent filter in your Androidmanifest.xml with the Google Now search action, as shown in this example. Once you make these changes to your manifest, your search activity will receive the search action intent. The intent will contain a search manager query extra with the exact search expression spoken by the user. It's up to you to provide the actual search implementation in your app, for example, using the on-device SQLite and FTS3. A few simple changes to your app will let your users search using voice, using Google Now Actions. For more information, check out the link on the screen.